Barakatha Yahweh, Barakatha Yahushah, Barakatha Yahweh, Barakatha Yahushah, Barakatha Yahweh, Barakatha Yahushah, Bahashon, Rakakwadash. Double honor to our apostles and elders of Great Millstone, who still well. Peace and blessing to the hopeful elect of Israel. Shalom. This is your brother Kazak from GMS Mississippi Camp. And today I want to deal with the topic of not denying Yahushah. Don't deny Yahushah because you think you're going to die. Because we're facing imminent death. Especially now with this latest news is going on with the new face of terrorism. So this frees a lot of Hebrew Israelites away. A lot of Hebrew Israelites, and I'm talking about what you could call practicing Hebrew Israelites, those that know who they are and those that teach that, a lot of them are going to deny the faith. They're going to denounce Yahweh Bashem Yahushah because they're faced or approached with death. But you know better, man. You know better. And first and foremost, Esau, he can't put you to death if the Lord don't allow it, man. He can't do that. Everything is sanctioned, man. Everything is orchestrated from the heavens. But let me get into some scriptures. And I hope this is edifying, okay? Let's go to 2 Timothy chapter 2, verse 10. Second Timothy 2 and 10. Therefore, I endure all things for the elect's sake. Therefore, I endure all things for the elect's sakes, that they may also obtain the salvation which is in Hamashiach Yahushah with eternal glory. You know what a part of that is? You being faced with death. You got to endure that too. Whether it happens or it doesn't happen, if you're approached with it, if it's brought to you, and you got to make a decision, and it just so happens that that's your lot, the lot falls on you to be put to death, you got to go through with that, man. And when I say you, I'm talking about me, I'm talking about everyone, man. Okay? All of us that are involved in this truth. But your end is eternal life. That's your expectation. It is a faithful saying. For if we be dead with him, we shall also live with him. And that's the thing, man. You can't kill what's already dead. We're already dead, man. You don't have a life here. Okay? So you're dead and you have a shot. He's going to be the one to give you your life. You're not living right now. But when he comes back, he's going to give you a life, man. A real life. For if we be dead with him, we shall also live with him. If we suffer, we shall also reign with him. Okay, and you being brought before governors and kings, you know, for a testimony unto them. Okay? And this is about to happen, man. It's happened before, it's going to happen again. It's happened during the time of the apostles. When you read in the book of Acts, it's going to happen all over again, man. In our time, this is Acts all over again. And there are going to be people that are going to falsely accuse you, man. This recent psyop, man, that's false accusation, man. Okay? It is a faithful saying, for if we be dead with him, we shall also live with him. If we suffer, we shall also reign with him. If we deny him, he also will deny us. And that's the thing, man. You don't want to get caught up in that. Okay? Because someone is going to fulfill this. And you don't want to fulfill this because you're fulfilling prophecy one way or another. You don't want that to be you, though. Denying the Lord. Well, he's going to turn around and deny you. And the only example that I can give of someone denying Yahushua, But that person was not denied is the Apostle Peter, the head of the church, which if you know the Bible, you know that the Apostle Peter is King David in the reincarnation. That's the reason why he was still accepted, man. That's David himself, you know? That's why he was the only one that could deny the Lord, but get a pass on it, which he denied the Lord for a purpose. But at the same time, we have that written for our example, so we don't turn around and do the same thing. Because who's to say we're going to get those sure mercies, man? Ultimately, the house of David, which are the elect, they're going to receive those sure mercies, but you don't want to test those waters, man. Okay? But let me deal with that. Since I'm speaking on the Apostle Peter, let's deal with that. First of all, let's get the words of Yahweh Shai. And then we'll get the words of the Apostle Peter, and we're going to get the account. Okay? Because, see, we're in a time where, hey, man, this is it now. This is the very end. So Esau, he's going to pull out all the tricks, man. All the slates, all the smoke. Hey, Esau won't smoke with us, man. You see, I'm burning incense right now. But he won't smoke with the prophets. He wants to put us to death. He wants to torture us, man. This nigga mad as hell. Esau mad as hell, man. Okay? But see, don't let this fucking fray you, man. A lot of y'all niggas getting scared, man. Not to call you niggas. Esau a real nigga. You wouldn't call us black Hebrew Israelites. He's the nigga. He's the black person. You know, they're people of darkness, man. Esau, Edomites are, they're dark spirited, man. Okay, but hey, man, you Jace, man, stop being fucking afraid, man. Okay? Don't let this shit, fray you. Don't let it detour you from the truth. Don't let it take you away from the truth, man. Okay, now, let me get the account of what our Lord said, and then let's get the actual account of what happened with the Apostle Peter. I'll say disciple Peter, first because he was a disciple before he became an apostle. Matthew 10 and verse 32. Whosoever therefore shall confess me before men, him will I confess also before my Father, which is in heaven. Let me read that again. Whosoever therefore shall confess me before men, and you're doing that by teaching. You're confessing the Lord now. Okay? Him will I confess also before my Father, which is in heaven. Right. So he's doing that right now. He's on the right-hand side of the Father. Okay? And he's confessing you before his Father. You know? But whosoever shall deny me before men, him will I also deny before my Father, which is in heaven. Now, that wasn't the case. That wasn't the case with the disciple Peter. Why? Because like I said, that's King David, man. You know? And if you're spiritual, you can see that. But the point is, you're confessing the Lord right now. You don't want to be in the lot of denying the Lord when all hell breaks loose. Because it's easy to teach when it becomes routine. But on a deeper level, man, this thing is not just about teaching. It's about living the truth. They that preach the gospel shall live by the gospel. This got to be your life. So when you faced with imminent death, if Esau have you hemmed up in a concentration camp, and it's going to happen to a lot of brothers, hey, man, you don't got nothing to lose. Any damn way. You don't have a life right now. That's how you got to think. And you got to know that Yahweh Shai is with you. Now, let me get one more scripture of what our Lord said, then I'm going to get that account. This is Revelation chapter 3 and verse 8. I know thy works. Behold, you know what? Let me start at verse 7. He's talking to the church in Philadelphia. Revelation 3 and 7. And to the angel of the church in Philadelphia write, these things saith he that is holy, he that is true, He that hath the key of David, he that openeth and no man shutteth, and shutteth and no man openeth. And see, that's the thing, man. That's why you got to believe in Yahweh Shai. He's the only individual that can take this truth away from you, man. Because he's the only person that opened you up to the truth in the first place. Esau can't take this truth from you, man. All right? And the key of David, man, that's this knowledge. You have it. You got the keys to the kingdom, man. You have access to Yahweh Bashim Yahweh Shai. Esau can't take that from you. I know thy works. Behold, I have set before thee an open door. That open door is your mind. So he opened your mind up to this truth. And no man can shut it. Like Esau. Esau can't shut you out the truth. Esau can't shut this knowledge away from you. And no man can shut it. For thou hast a little strength and has kept my word and has not denied my name. Right. So from that time, when this is written, up until now. So you got to fulfill this, man. And we pray and hope that Yahweh Bashim Yahweh Shai puts the spirit on us to fulfill that. Because there's no free will. Now let me get the account of the disciple Peter. Let's go to Matthew. Matthew chapter 26. Okay, this is the book of Matthew, chapter 26, and verse 33. Peter answered and said unto him, though all men shall be offended because of thee, yet will I never be offended. So that's how he truly felt, right? You know, if it was his will, he would not have denied the Lord, right? But let's see what Yahweh Shai said. Yahweh Shai said unto him, verily, which means truly, I say unto you, verily I say unto thee, that this night before the cock crow, thou shalt deny me thrice, meaning three times. Peter said unto him, though I should die with thee, yet will I not deny thee. Likewise also said all the disciples. But you know what? When the time of persecution came, you know what happened? The disciples, they hauled ass, man. You know, I mean, they broke loose. You know what I'm saying? They scattered, you know, because they didn't want to die. But that was written for our learning. You know, it's no disrespect to the disciples. Those are the Lord's apostles, excluding Judas, you know. Judas, he's not written in the book of life, you know, but they were all scattered, and that was also pursuant to prophecy, you know, in the book of Zechariah. You know, smite the shepherd, and the sheep shall be scattered. You know, so they cut loose, and let's see what the apostle, disciple first, you know, disciple, which became an apostle, dealing with Peter. Let's see what he did during that hour of temptation that the Lord had to go through. Let's just read it for what it says, okay? Matthew 26 and 69. Now Peter sat without, meaning outside, in the palace. And a damsel came unto him, saying, thou also was with Yahweh Shai of Galilee. But he denied before them all, saying, I know not what thou sayest. And you know what? He didn't want to do this. The disciple Peter, he did not want to deny the Lord, man. He didn't want to do that. None of us would want to do that. But certain men are going to do it. Okay? Which, once again, the only reason why this happened was for our learning, but also because Yahweh Shai, he had to go through that moment by himself. He had to go through it by himself, man. You know, that's why the disciples, they dipped on him. That's why the disciple Peter ended up denying him. And he didn't want to do it, and they didn't want to leave. But that happened because the Lord had to go through that all by himself. You know? Also, another thing. Like the elder apostles of Great Millstone say, you're really in this truth by yourself, man. That's why the scriptures say to work out thine own salvation with fear and trembling. You know? You're really in this thing alone, man, because a lot of people are going to betray you in that day. And you're going to see it. Y'all going to see it, man. A lot of people that know you, a lot of people that work with you, a lot of family members, old friends, they all going to be talking shit about you. And they all going to tell on you to Esau to save their own ass, man. But see, we can't have that spirit. The reason why a lot of men and women are going to denounce Yahweh Bashem Yahushua because they want to save their own ass. You can't think like that, man. You got to be selfless, not selfish. All right? Now, let me read some more. Matthew 26 and 71. And when he was gone out into the porch, another maid saw him and said unto them that were there, this fellow was also with Yahusha of Nazareth. And again, he denied with an oath. So he swore. But he was lying, you know, because he was with Yahusha. Okay? But, you know, it reads, and again, he denied with an oath, I do not know the man. And after a while came unto him they that stood by and said to Peter, surely thou also art one of them, for thy speech bereft thee. Right, you talk just like them. You know, you speaking that Hebrew dialect. You sound like you came up in Galilee. We could tell you was around your house shot. Then began he to curse and to swear, saying, I know not the man. And immediately the cock crew. Right? So he was convicted, man. He was like, oh, shit. Well, let me read some more. And Peter remembered the word of Yahushua, which said unto him, before the cock crow, thou shalt deny me thrice. And he went out and wept bitterly. And he felt bad, man. He felt bad. But let me read a scripture. Let me get another scripture. Romans, the book of Romans, which you brothers know where I'm going, all right? Romans chapter 15 and verse 4. For whatsoever things were written aforetime were written for our learning, that we through patience and comfort of the scriptures might have hope. And that word patience, it means to suffer. Okay? To be patient, that requires suffering, man, because you got to wait. And you suffer while you wait, you know? Because it's delayed gratification, man. This society teaches you instant gratification. But with the Lord, you got to wait, man. You got to be long-suffering. But the point is, that was all written to show us that you got to still stay faithful, man. You know, even in the face of adversity, because this shit about to get chaotic. Esau, he's about to go berserk, man. Why? He's about to lose everything. And once he loses it this time, he's never going to get it back. He's never going to get it back again, all right? There's not going to be another rebirth, another renaissance, okay? There's not going to be another colonial age of Edom. Him colonizing every damn thing. Okay, by way of the Spanish, by way of the French, by way of the British. That's not going to happen again, man. This nigga is about to lose everything. And I'm talking about Esau, the real black person, which really they're red people, okay, they're Edomites. But when I say black, I mean evil. The people of darkness, man, the Edomites, they're wicked, and they're going to show you they're wicked. You know, everything's a fucking joke right now, man. Everybody want to fucking have fun. But you going to see, we ain't coming to some fun times, man. You know, we're speaking on Yahusha, you know, going through that time of temptation, man, by himself. You're going to go through this shit by yourself, man. And it's going to feel cold, all right? It's going to be a cold time, man. You know, but, man, let me get Revelation 12 and 11. Because you're going to see who's with you in that day, man. Revelation chapter 12, verse 11. And they overcame him, overcame who? Overcame Esau. And they overcame him by the blood of the Lamb, the blood of Yahushua, and by the word of their testimony, the prophecies, okay? And they loved not their lives until the death. Right. So we don't love our life, man. And if you don't love your life, you don't care to keep it. You know? Now, we're not up here contemplating suicide and shit. We're not going to off ourselves. But I'm making a point. We don't care about dying, man. Because I just read, we love not our lives until the death. So when Esau comes for you, he's going to come for brothers, man. And when he throws you in a damn internment camp, makeshift camp, concentration camp, FEMA camp, whatever you want to call it, a detention center, re-education center, when he puts you up in there, and when he threatens you, excuse me, when he threatens you with death, he tells you, take this microchip, or we're going to think you're a terrorist. Because that's what they're going to do, brothers. They're going to threaten you with death, and they're going to tell you, they're going to give you a choice. They're going to say, you need to take this chip, you need to take this microchip, or we're going to put you to death because you're a terrorist. But don't cop out, man. Okay? And another thing, too, basically, you denouncing or denying Yahusha, it doesn't necessarily mean you saying that you don't believe in Yahusha. You can just simply be denouncing that you're a Hebrew Israelite. That's denying to have a shot. Well, let me get a scripture, man. Let me get a couple scriptures, right? Let's go to Psalms chapter 40. Psalms chapter 40 and verse 7. Then said I, lo, I come, and the volume of the book it is written of me. Right? So Yahusha, he's the word. Okay? If you believe in the word, you believe in Yahusha by default, because he is the word. Okay? And if you believe in the word, you believe you're a Hebrew Israelite, you believe in your nationality, but you denying Yahusha, you denying the word, you're denying your nationality. Ultimately. So just by you simply saying that you're not affiliated with this, you're not a part of the what Esau calls the Black Hebrew Israelite movement, you just saying that you don't want nothing to deal with it, you don't want nothing to do with it, you simply saying that, you're denying Yahusha. Okay? You just simply saying you want nothing to do with this, that's denying Yahusha. Because he's the word, he's the truth. We believe in him, right? You should believe in him. You saying you don't want nothing to do with it, you're denying the Lord, man. And yourself, because you know who you really are. You know? But, hey, it's about to be hell on earth, man. You know, the reason why I'm bringing this out, I'm going into this, because a lot of people are going to cop out. You want to know why? Jake wants that easy way out. But you're going to come to find out, ain't no easy way out. It ain't no easy way out. And you know what? Even if you deny Yahusha by you simply denying you're a Hebrew Israelite, even if you do that, Esau gonna kill your ass any damn way. Esau gonna put you to death any damn way. Do you know the devil you're dealing with? Esau, he broke over 500 treaties with the tribe of Gad, so-called North American Indians. What the hell make you think they gonna keep their word now? This nigga don't give a damn about lying. He don't give a damn about blood. He showed you with his recent psyop, he'll put his own people to death just to blame you. Okay? And that shit look tacky as hell, man. You can tell that ain't real, man. But sticking to the point, Esau don't give a damn. You deny who you are. You deny you have a shot. He gonna kill you any damn way, man. And let me get a scripture on that. Okay? Which I'm rolling in the spirit. I wrote some scripts down. I got scriptures wrote down, but I'm still going in the spirit, all right? Because the word needs to have free course. Amen. You're going to come to find out a lot of people ain't with you. You know, for a lot of you brothers, and even you few sisters that believe, for those of you that live with your family, or let's say your family knows that you're a part of this thing. I don't want to say, you know, a religion. It ain't no religion. Okay? But they know you're a Hebrew Israelite, which they're Hebrew Israelites too. This ain't something that you convert to. You can't convert to a nationality. It's who you are. But they know that you're what's called a practicing Hebrew Israelite. You're keeping the law, statutes, and commandments. Okay? You go out on the street and you teach as far as you brothers. You know, for you sisters out there, you keep your heads covered. You know, you pray to Yahweh while Yahweh Shai. Okay? You watch the videos, and a lot of your family members know this. A lot of people that you work around, they may know who you are. But you're going to see when all hell breaks loose, they don't give a damn. They're going to turn your ass in, man. A lot of them. Once again, we're the new face of terrorism, but this shouldn't make you afraid. Okay? But it's the reality you have to deal with. The reason why the Lord, Yahweh Shem Yahweh Shai, has this happening to show you that it's real. Okay? This thing is real, man. It's not a fucking game. You know? 2 Ezra chapter 16 and verse 68. For behold, the burning wrath of a great multitude is kindled over you. Right? What it tells you in Revelation 12 and 12. The devil has come down with great wrath because he knoweth that he had but a short time. So it says right here in the Apocrypha in 2 Ezra 16 and 68, for behold, the burning wrath of a great multitude is kindled over you. Who's the great multitude? The elite of Esau, the host of the high ones that are on high, the kings of the earth, the ruling elite. That's the great multitude. All right? The wealthy families of the earth, which are Edomites. And you have other nations a part of it, but really, for the most part, it's Edomites. It's Esau's world. So they're mad as hell, man. The burning wrath of a great multitude is kindled over us. You think it's not going to happen? You think we're not in this time? For you people that's fucking playing games? All right? You men and women. You want to fucking play games? Man, the Most High about to make Esau move. All right? Ain't no fucking game, man. A lot of people about to die, man. All right? Men, women, children. People about to fucking die, all right? Shit about to get real, man. And we gonna see who really believe. A lot of you men and women, you ain't gonna believe in that day. Your ass is gonna be like, hey, fuck this shit. Let me get from around y'all. That's how you gonna be, you know? And they shall take away certain of you and take you where? Hey, what does it tell you in Revelation? Let me get it. It says Esau mad as hell, and they're going to take away certain of us. Now, the question is, where are they going to take you? Revelation chapter 2 and verse 10. Fear none of those things which thou shalt suffer. Behold, the devil, Esau, shall cast some of you into prison. And that's the point right there, man. They shall take away certain of you and put you in prison, which is what? A concentration camp. A concentration camp is basically a prison. It's the same damn thing, man. It's the same damn thing. In any large building, any large facility, or even a small facility, okay, can be made into a concentration camp. A damn supermarket can be made into a concentration camp. All right? A damn Coliseum. You name it. But they actually have concentration camps set up here in North America. Babylon the Great. All right? These camps are fully operational. Fully operational. Fully loaded. Ready to go, man. It's real. And you're going to see it, man. It's not no fucking conspiracy theory. It's not a conspiracy theory. They shall take away certain of you, back in 2 Ezra 16 to 68, and they shall take away certain of you and feed you, being idle with things offered unto idols. Now, what's that talking about? They're going to seek to re-educate you. They're going to be doing psychological warfare on your minds. All right? Feeding you with the philosophies of the New World Order. Telling you, you better take this chip or you're going to be a terrorist. If you're a terrorist, we got to put you to death. That's how it's going to be, man. And a lot of Hebrew Israelites, they know that Hebrew Israelites are going to take the damn chip, man. Why? They don't want to deal with the straight gate. They want the easy way out, man. Ain't no fucking easy way out, man. Ain't no easy way out. And feed you being idle with things offered unto idols. And ultimately, the idols will be them. Because they want to be the gods of the planet Earth, man. And if you take that chip, that's you denouncing or denying Yahweh, why Yahweh Shah, and you saying that Esau is your God. You know? So we're in a time when this is about to happen, man. You don't want this to be you. That's why you got to take this serious, man. None of us want this to be us, man. But that's why Yahweh Shah said, because thou hast kept the word of my patience, I will also keep thee or protect thee from the hour of temptation. Meaning the Lord is going to put the spirit on you to refrain from taking the chip. He's going to put the spirit on you to resist, getting the chip. Back in 2 Ezra 16 and 69. And they that consent unto them shall be had in derision and in reproach and trodden underfoot. You know what that means? There's going to be men and women that know that they're Hebrew Israelites that are going to deny the faith. They're going to comply. Okay? They're going to compromise themselves. They're going to be like, you know what? I don't want to die. Fuck that. Let me get the chip. Let me chip my children. You know? That's how they're going to be. But you know what, man? In these times, you got to be cold. Okay? You got to be cold. You got to be numb to every goddamn thing. You got to be callous. You got to be hard to it. And what I mean by that, if Esau threatens you with death, fuck it, die. If he threatens your family members, they got to die. Rather than you deny your how about Shinya was shot, you know, if he got to slit their damn throat in front of you, if he has to slit their throats in front of you, hey, that movie, Unthinkable. The movie Unthinkable starring Samuel L. Jackson, when he was torturing that one guy that was a Muslim that hid all those different bombs. That shit real, man. You think Esau don't do shit like that? You don't think they gonna do some shit like, hey man, what happened recently, you know, on Tuesday, that PSYOP, okay, that shooting of the so-called Jewish supermarket, they said that the people that did it were black Hebrew Israelites, as Esau calls us, and they also said they were hiding a damn pipe bomb in their U-Haul truck, you know, in their van. So hiding bombs, hey, like I said, that movie Unthinkable. So you got that one saying, art imitates life. Art imitates life. So Esau, he's basically showing you what he's going to do before he does it, man. That's his way of prophesying. Okay, but he's showing you he's setting these things up, man. Okay? All these different psychological operations, all these false flag terror attacks. Okay? He's going to come for us, man, but he has to justify coming for us to the world. He has to really make us look like the problem to the planet Earth. When he's the problem, man, he's the one chemtrailing your air, poisoning your water with fluoride. Okay? He's the one making your sons and daughters rebel against you, man. Indoctrinating them with the philosophies of the New World Order up in these different, you know, public schools. He's doing that, man. Got your woman against you. Making your woman be independent. Esau doing that, man. We're not the problem. He's the problem. LGBTQP. This transgender movement. He behind that, man. We're not doing that shit. But the point is, he's going to accuse us because he's the accuser of our brethren. Like the scriptures say. I read that in the video earlier, man. All right? Revelation 12 and 10. But the point is, man, he's going to roll. But before he rolls on us, he has to justify it. Okay? Because as you can see, he's accusing us to the whole world, man. To the whole planet. 2 Ezra 16 and 69 again. And they that consent unto them, so those of you that take that damn chip because Esau threatened you with death, and they that consent unto them shall be had in derision. What's derision? Look the word derision up. It means laughing stock. You know what that means? That means you take that damn chip and you deny your how about Shemiah shot. You know what Esau gonna do? Look at this stupid ass nigga. I made him take the chip. I got him take the chip. Look at this dumbass Native American. Look at this dumbass Mexican. And I'm talking about those of you that know that you're Hebrew Israelites, but you deny the faith in that time. You know, look at this dumbass Dominican or this dumbass Puerto Rican. He's going to be saying these things because he got you to take that damn chip. This dumbass Jamaican. Whatever, you know, he's going to make fun of you, man. Because he knows who you are, but he's going to be like, you know, hey, I got through this motherfucker, man. I got him. So he's going to relish it, okay? Make fun of you. They shall be had in derision and in reproach and trodden underfoot. You know what that means? Once again, you're going to die anyway. You take that chip, you deny the faith, you're going to die any damn way. Because if it ain't Esau you're dealing with, you got to deal with your how about Shemiel Shah. Which is all a test anyway, man. It's all a test. And we all gonna be tested, all right? Now let me read some more. We're in this time, brothers. We are in this time. Take it serious, man. Because YouTube ain't about to be here. Just, man, it came out today. Look it up. They're banning hate speech on YouTube, man. And what we're doing is so-called hate speech, all right? This is put up on BBC News today. During the same time this PSYOP is going out. Okay? Lord will, I can do a video on that a little later, man. But they're banning what they call hate speech, man. So the famine of the word is inevitable. So YouTube ain't about to be here forever, man. Us preaching this word is not going to be forever. Because like Elder Apostle Gabor said through the Spirit, things change, man. Nothing remains the same. There are stages, all right? Nothing stays the same. So we're not going to be teaching forever. You know? Just to name some of the different, you know, titles. Elder Apostle Hart gave these different years, man. You had the year of the push. You had the year of prophecy. Now you have the year of Karagma, okay? So, hey man, all hell about to break loose next, man. And that's if we're here another year. Because next year can be our last year, man. Okay? But let me read some more. 2 Ezra 16 and verse 70. For there shall be in every place, woo! Not just America. Hey man, for you brothers that teach in London, hey, that article, it was on BBC, all right? Dealing with the hate speech on YouTube. So for you brothers that teach in London, you brothers in Holland, you brothers in Jamaica, you brothers in Peru, you brothers in Bolivia, you brothers in Australia, you brothers in South Africa, all right? Man, it's brothers everywhere, man. Brothers in Central America, Costa Rica, brother in Puerto Rico, brother in Germany, all right? You brothers all throughout the states of America, this is about to happen. 2 Ezra 16 and 70, for there shall be in every place and in the next cities a great insurrection upon those that fear the Lord, Yahweh Shem El Shai. Esau coming, man. This hasn't happened yet. It's about to happen. This ain't talking about 70 AD. All right? This is talking about now, man. This time. This time, man. And you got to just embrace it, man. You know, Yahweh Shem El Shai, we're part of the elect. You know, amen. We're definitely the prophets through the Spirit, man. We got to be. You know, Lord willing, I say that boldly, but Lord willing, hey, man, this is the end, man. This is the end, okay? That's the faith that you got to hold to. This thing is happening, man. It's happening, all right? Man, a great insurrection upon those that fear the Lord. So Esau, he got a stage set. He's setting his case up, and he's going to roll on us, man. Those of us that know, all right? You know. You know, so guess what? You're a threat. You're a threat to his system, man. And it's no coincidence. It's Amalek, these so-called Jewish people that claim to be us. It's no coincidence. They're the ones behind this, man. You notice no one else is behind this. They're behind this, man. You want to know why? Hey, man, go back to the Old Testament. Read in Exodus. Read in Deuteronomy. When we came up out of Egypt, when we were traveling in the wilderness, we had war with Amalek, man. We were fighting with Amalek. And you know what was said? It was said that we would have war with Amalek from generation to generation. That's even till the end, man. To this time. It's Amalek doing this shit, man. And they know who they are. They're the ones behind the media. Accusing you, man. Accusing us. Hey, man. These people are satanic, man. They're satanic. All right? You're going to see who the devil is, all right? Now it says, they shall be like madmen, sparing none, but still spoiling and destroying those that fear the Lord. Now, on a bigger level, the overview is pretty much Esau making war against the whole nation of Israel. And when I say the whole nation of Israel, I'm talking about all so-called Negroes, Latinos, Hispanics, and Native American Indians. Okay? Those of you that don't even know who you are, he's coming for you too. It's all out war against the whole nation, man. Not just those of us that know, even those of you that don't know. He's coming for everybody, man. He's making war against the whole nation of Israel. This devil like, I'm losing my kingdom. Man, fuck it. I'm coming for all y'all, man. This is mindset. He's coming for everybody, man. He don't give a damn, okay? Hey, man, Esau, his mind state is like, hey, man, fuck y'all. If I'm going out, I'm taking you with me. That's Esau's thinking, man. If I gotta go, I'm taking you with me. Which, you're not gonna take us with you, man. You're going to slavery alone. And you're gonna be under us. America's gonna be destroyed, and you're going down. Okay? They shall be like madmen, sparing none, but still spoiling and destroying those that fear the Lord. So, when martial law is declared, they're gonna murder a lot of Hebrew Israelites, man. They're going to murder, man. They're going to bring mass death, all right? This some shit you can't even put in a movie, man. It's going to be that bugged out. But don't fret. Don't stress. Don't go crazy. Don't lose your damn mind. It's supposed to happen, man. I'm reading it right now. It's reality. You know, you got to think about the reality of it. But don't let it make you afraid, man. You know? Hey, man, fuck Esau. Let him do what he do. Let him do what he does best, man. Be the devil. Let him be the devil, okay? He's supposed to do this. They should be like madmen, and a mad person is a crazy person. an insane person, okay? Sparing none, but still spoiling and destroying those that fear the Lord, which are the Israelites. For they shall waste and take away their goods and cast them out of their houses. Right? And it's going to be different times of the day, man. Hey, man, it could be like 2 o'clock in the morning, 3 o'clock, 4 o'clock in the morning, 5 o'clock in the morning. You know? But early in the morning, busting down your door, man, with a damn battering ram. You know, snatching you up. You, your wife, your children, throwing you in some damn black vans or black SUVs. You know, putting you in some damn boxcar trains. All right? And taking you to the nearest camp. That's what they're going to be doing, man. And it's a spirit because last night I was watching El Apostle Gabbar's old video that he did on that one trailer, Grace State. You know, which, hey man, that trailer, it sums it all up. It sums it all up what Esau was about to do, man. Okay? Hey man, I gotta re-upload that video again, or that lesson that the elder apostle had did, man. On that trailer, which was supposed to be a movie, Grace State. And that movie never came out. But instead, they had this damn agent provocateur shield, this government shield, Alex Jones, make a damn fake Grace State movie. That shit fake, man. That shit that was put up on Netflix, that's not the real Grace State that was supposed to come out, man. You know, because the guy that was behind that trailer, Grace State, you know, who was producing or was, you know, in the making of, you know, producing that film, the film never came out because that guy got put to death, man. The government moved in on his ass. They put him and his whole family to death for making that, you know, that movie. They put an end to it, you know? But the point is, man, hey, man, why did he do that, man? Why did Esau put that man to death, him and his family? Because that movie that never came out, Grace State, it showed you what's about to happen. This new world order, man, was Esau bringing a totalitarian system, policing the whole earth, okay? Martial law being declared, curfews being set up, mandatory microchipping of the masses of people, okay? And people being decapitated for refusing to take the chip, man. They showed you that, man. People being beheaded, getting their heads chopped off, man. This shit fucking real, man. It's real, okay? And that's another reason why a lot of people gonna deny the faith, man. They don't wanna be put to death. Which I don't mean to, you know, rant so much, but I'm in the spirit. Esau gonna do this, okay? He's gonna do it. And I'm reading it right now. 2 Ezra 16 and verse 72 again. For they shall waste and take away their goods and cast them out of their houses. It's gonna happen. It ain't happened yet, but it's gonna happen. Then shall there be known who are my chosen, and they shall be tried as the gold in the fire. Right? So it's gonna be known who the chosen of Israel are. It's gonna be known who the elect are, because they're going to be defended. Because see, the balance to this whole thing is that the Lord is going to endow his men with spiritual power. But also, the Lord is going to put his men in certain situations where it's going to look like there's no way out, but he's going to come through, man. Whether it's a host of angels that they just come and break you out of a camp, you know, bust you out of a concentration camp, or the Lord give you the spirit to just go through that thing. Let's say if you are beheaded, but it's going to do nothing but amplify the truth. That's all it's going to do. Let's say if you're a martyr and you're put to death for your Yahweh Hashem Yahweh Shai, it's going to do nothing but make this truth expand. That's all it's going to do. Because I just read, you will be tried as the gold in the fire. That's happening right now. And it's going to happen when that persecution comes, man. You got to go through that affliction. Hey, it's going to be hard, man. It's going to be hell, but hey, man, we can do it, man. The Lord got us this far, okay? Hey, man, Elder Apostle Gabriel was speaking about how Esau came for them during 9/11. But guess what? The Lord got them out of that, man. And you other brothers, man, out there that have been teaching for a while, you've been locked up for the word, a lot of brothers. But guess what? You got broken out, so to speak, man. The Lord got you out of that situation. You were let out of prison. But let me make a point. It's all about balance. There's going to be certain men that are put to death for the testimony of Yahweh Shai. But on the flip side, there's going to be other men that are going to be defended. Okay? They will be defended, meaning they're going to get that power and the Lord is going to lift up a standard for them, man. That's the balance. Okay? Now I'm going to give my closing scriptures because through the Spirit I said enough. Okay? Because see, once Esau rolls on us, the Most High gonna roll on him. So let him do what he does, man. Be the devil. Okay? Isaiah chapter 41 and verse 11. Isaiah 41 and 11. Behold, all they that were incensed against thee shall be ashamed and confounded. They shall be as nothing, and they that strive with thee shall perish. Right? Now, who's incensed against us? Esau. Amen. Jay got that one saying on the street, how you won't smoke. Somebody won't smoke. Meaning, they got beef with you, right? Well, Esau has beef with us. They won't smoke with us. But guess what? The Most High won't smoke them, okay? Because incense is smoke, all right? It's like you brothers, you burn incense. I was just burning some a minute ago. You know, but Esau, he's mad, he's angry. I just read about that great wrath, that burning wrath they have against us, you know? So it's like a smoke. They're on fire against us. They want to take us out, man. Thou shalt seek them and shall not find them. Yeah, so you're going to be like, man, where that whole army at that just came up against me? You know? All these people thought they was going to put me to death. Where the hell they go? That's how it's going to be. Because you're going to be defended. Okay? Their power. Thou shalt seek them and shall not find them. Even them that contended with thee. Those fighting against you. That wanted to put you to death. They that war against thee shall be as nothing and as a thing of naught. Right. They're going to be nothing, man. You know? Because the Lord is with us. But you got to believe it. You have to believe it. And I believe it, man. And I believe it to the point to where even if certain of us got to be put to death, with certain men are going to die. But even if that got to happen, the Lord's still with us. Even unto death. And the scriptures say that, man. This is why the scriptures say, strive for the truth unto death, and the Lord shall fight for thee. Because even if you die in the flesh, you're going to be raised up. You're going to be raised up, all right? Now let me get Isaiah chapter 59 and verse 19. So shall they fear the name of the Lord, Yahweh Shai, from the west. And we're in the western hemisphere, and his glory from the rising of the sun, from the east. When the enemy, who's the enemy? Esau, shall come in like a flood. You have a thing that's called stormtroopers. They move in like a flood, okay? So those martial law troops, ultimately. When the enemy shall come in like a flood, the spirit of Yahweh Shemiah Shai shall lift up a standard against him. Right, and an example of that is when you look at the prophet Elijah, when you had those men that was coming for him, that was sent by King Ahab to bring the prophet Elijah to him. And you know what happened? Fire came down from heaven and consumed those men. All right? Consumed that captain and his 50 men. Read the account. You know? So the spirit of Yahweh Shemiah was shy. Lifted up a standard against them men, man, to defend the prophet Elijah. Not to mention, when you read in our history, dealing with the Assyrians, you had Sennacherib. He had sent one of his ambassadors to Jerusalem to confront King Hezekiah and to confront the elders of Israel. To pretty much be in obeisance and submit themselves to King Sennacherib, all right? But guess what, man? The men of Israel, hey, they cried to Yahweh Shemiah Shai for the Lord to help them. And you know what the Lord did? Hey, man, the Lord sent a death angel. And that death angel put thousands of those Assyrian soldiers to death, man. That's what happened. Well, you know what? Let me look for it really quick. I'm in the book of Isaiah. And in history, it's in the book of Kings, but it's also in the book of Isaiah. All right? You brothers, just give me a second really quick. All right? Isaiah. Woo! Man. Isaiah chapter 37. And I just want to get the point. Like I said, you brothers, bear with me really quick, man. All right, here we go right here. Listen to this. Isaiah chapter 37 and verse 36. Then the angel of Yahweh went forth and smote, meaning kill, put to death, and smote in the camp of the Assyrians 180. So 180 and 5,000. And that's one angel. One angel took out all these Assyrians, man. Then the angel of Yahweh went forth and smote in the camp of the Assyrians 180 and 5,000. And when they arose early in the morning, behold, they were all dead corpses. Yeah. Hey, so the Heavenly Father, man, the Heavenly Father, Yahweh, has a strong way of proving his point that he's with his people. So whether it's you getting spiritual power for yourself or the Lord having a hedge about you, the Lord having you fortified or protected, those holy angels surrounding you and protecting you so that no harm comes to you. Either way, you're going to be all right, man. But let's just say, for example, if, and I'm saying if because we don't know, but let's say if it's your lot, if the lot falls on you to die, because that means it's written. Your story, which is a part of this story, you know, the scriptures, it's written, you're one of those men that was meant to go out that way. And if that happens, then hey, you're going to be all right. Because you're still written in the book of life anyway. That was just your lot, you know? Which, you know, when you go into heavens, you're still a part of the saints, man. You know? And when I say saints, I not only mean the nation of Israel as a whole, because the whole nation of Israel are saints. But I mean, you're part of that chosen elect, man. You're part of the elect, okay? And everything is in order in the heavens, man. Everything is balanced, you know, and it's separated. You know, because you have all Israel, there are the people of the Most High, but the elect, they're really close to Yahweh Bashim Yahushua. You know? So when you go to the heavens, man, hey, the Lord is gonna smile at you, right? Hey, you're gonna be alright. You're gonna be alright if you go out that way and that's it. Hey man, you still good, because when you get raised up, you're coming back with the Lord anyway. You know? But since I said that, let me get one more scripture, then I'm going to close this out, right? In the Apocrypha, Wisdom of Solomon, chapter 3. Wisdom of Solomon, chapter 3, and verse 1. But the souls of the righteous are in the hand of the Most High, and there shall no torment touch them. In the sight of the unwise, they seem to die, and their departure is taken from misery, and they're going from us to be utter destruction, but they are in peace. Right? So, if you got to die for this word, you're going to be in peace, man. And I'm speaking on this because shit about to get real. It's about to get real. For though they be punished in the sight of men, yet is their hope full of immortality. And having been a little chastised, they shall be greatly rewarded, for the Most High proved them and found them worthy for himself. As gold in the furnace have he tried them and received them as a burnt offering. Right, so you're an acceptable sacrifice to Yahweh Bashim Yahusha. That's all. And that was your lot once again. But it said, you shall be greatly rewarded. You're getting beamed up, received up into glory, getting beamed up in a chariot, or you just coming back with Yahusha. Like it tells you in 1 Thessalonians chapter 4. Those that sleep in Yahusha shall the Most High Yahweh bring with them. Bring back with Yahusha on those chariots, man. Meaning, if you die in this truth, you're going to come back with the Lord on those chariots, on those ships. You know? So you already got your seat in the kingdom, basically. You already got it, man. As gold in the furnace have you tried them and received them as a burnt offering. Like I read in 2 Ezra 16, they shall be tried as the gold in the fire. Listen to this right here. And in the time of their visitation, they shall shine and run to and fro like sparks among the stubble. You know what that's talking about? That's talking about spiritual power. You endued with power from on high. Receiving that power from on high. Okay? That's what that's talking about. Running to and fro like sparks among the stubble. Hey man, a lot of you brothers, especially younger brothers that know about it, a lot of y'all watch Dragon Ball Z. When you see them, you know, those Super Saiyans, they're moving so fast, it's like, you know, it's like light or like sparks. It's like sparks, and you can't see them. That's like sparks among the stubble. Meaning you so fast, you can't even see the person move, man. That's spiritual power. And Esau knows a lot of brothers about to get that power, man. The evidence of that, you teaching the word, and all these chariots over us, man. Okay? You teaching the word, but as we're teaching the word, more chariots are popping up. There are more chariot sightings every single day, man. There was just another one a couple days ago over California, man. Would you brothers know about that account? You know about that recent sighting. You know, you can speak on it if you want to. You know, you can name the location. But it was just recently over California, all right? Which California, I looked it up today, California has a high volume of chariots, man, hovering over it, you know? You wanna know why? The word is going out high power in California, man. Hey, man, you got the brothers in Great Millstone in LA. You got the brothers in Great Millstone in the Bay Area, all right? The word going out high power, man. You got other brothers that's teaching the truth in other parts of California as well, okay? But it's a high volume of chariots over Cali, man. So Esau see it. You think he don't see that? But like I just read, even the brothers got to die for the testimony of Yahweh Shai. They're going to be raised up, and they're going to be raised up with that power, man. Okay? Not to mention brothers that won't have to experience that, brothers that won't die, but they're going to be faced with death, they're going to get that power too. Okay? And this is the end game right here. This is the end game. Let me read it. Wisdom of Solomon 3 and 8. They shall judge the nations and have dominion over the people, and their Lord, Yahweh Shai, because that word Lord, the L is a is a capital letter, but the rest is lowercase. So that word Lord is talking about Yahweh Shai. So they shall judge the nations and have dominion over the people, and their Lord, Yahweh Shai, shall reign forever. Hey, this is big, man. This is pinnacle. You know, it's pinnacle, man. You know? Woo! I don't know what to say, except for all praise to you. How about Yahweh Shai? Hey, man, you got the brother Michael Allen from LA. Hey, shalom, brother. And that brother be going in, man. You know, him and the other brothers, man. Them brothers, they be going in. But, you know, we know what time we in. You know, that's why our brother's going hard, man. You know? Hey, man, Esau can just say, fuck it, and cut the internet off tonight. You know? But you know what? Hey, do it, goddammit, because we tired of this shit, you know? Fuck it. Bring the end, man. Just, hey, do it. What the fuck you waiting for, Esau? E? You know? Which I gotta say it, man. The brothers out there in Cali, through the spirit, hey, they were saying that first, you know? Which, you know, it doesn't matter, but I'm making a point. I remember them saying, they were calling Esau E. They would say, bitch ass E, you know? Because Esau, and those spirit brothers saying that, because now we all saying E, because Esau being such a damn bitch, because he knows, hey man, this word is getting on his ass, man. The Most High is using us to get on Esau, you know? So now we gotta speak in code and just call him E, man. So brothers in Cali, what they were saying was through the spirit, man. Now we all calling you E. But you still know who you are. You know? And you know who we are, man. And at the end of the day, Jacob and Esau got to butt heads, man. You know? And this the end game. It's the end game. So for you brothers out there, man, you know, you afraid of confrontation. You know, this is bothering you. Hey, man, you better cast off that fearful spirit, man. Because at the end of the day, it's the end game. At the end of the day, it's going to be between Jacob and Esau. It's a face-off, man. It ain't no denying it, ain't no getting around it. Hey, man, you're going to be out in public. Esau will keep giving you strange looks. We in that time. You know? We in that time, man. It got to be a face-off, man. It's going to be to the point, man, really. We got to be like Yahweh Shai and really, man, be under the radar, man. I went to a damn coffee shop, you know, because I was getting some tea from there. You know, and I called in to get the tea. And you know, not to rant, but I'm just making a quick point, you know. I called into this damn coffee shop because I wanted some tea from there. It's a coffee shop, but they serve tea. And the damn Edomite bitch that worked there, this motherfucker going to tell me, it's a coffee shop, it's an espresso shop, and they don't serve tea. I'm like, man, you motherfucker. You know, I ain't said it on the phone, but I'm like, as many times I go to this goddamn coffee shop, I know good and damn well y'all serve tea. So you fucking lying, man. You know? But when I went there and I saw the damn Edomite that said the shit, she ain't had nothing to say, man. That motherfucking bitch, she was all smiles, man. All fucking smiles. Another incident, went to a different coffee shop, but you know what? Hey, man, Esau and Jacob, hey, it's just confrontation, man. And you're seeing it because it's happening to the prophets, man. And if it's going to happen to the prophets, what it tells you? Judgment shall begin at the house of the Most High, but then it's going to happen to the rest of Israel, man. But I went to another coffee shop, you know, and another Edomite, you know, hey, I was talking to this dude. I just, you know, wanted something to drink, man. Just getting my beverage, and I wanted to leave. And it sounded like this motherfucker said, nigga, man. And I had to, you know, correct him. I was like, man, what'd you say? You know what I'm saying? And he was super LGBT'd out, man. This dude had fingernail polish, you know, wearing some damn cut-off shorts and shit, green hair. But it sounded like he fucking said, nigga, man. You know, but I had to correct him. I'm like, man, what'd you say? And I got real serious, you know? And he was, man, I ain't say nothing. So we're in the time, brothers. This shit all happened recently. It all happened recently, man. So at the end of the day, hey, it got to be a face-off between Jacob and Esau. Ain't no denying it. Race wars got to happen. But don't let none of this shit make you afraid, man. You know? Hey, man, I had a vision that a lot of brothers in the troop was getting into with Esau, man. You know? On a physical level. But the Lord was defending us, man. The Lord was defending us. And you got to believe it. You got to believe it, man. You're going to be defended. All right? Don't fucking be afraid, man. Don't be afraid. Now, you know, since a lot of brothers are chiming in, you know, I'll pray to see how about Shemal Shai. I'm just going to read scriptures off the comment board, you know. And this is going to be it for this lesson here. All right? Yeah, man, Esau is through. Esau is through, and there's nothing he can do. Okay? It's by Prince Judea Maccabee. Genesis chapter 27 and verse 41. And Esau hated Jacob because of the blessing wherewith his father blessed him. And Esau said in his heart, the days of mourning for my father are at hand. And when you read the rest, he says how he's going to slay his brother Jacob. Esau still has that spirit, man. Okay? But it says how Esau hated Jacob because of the blessing. Because he knows you coming into power, man. And you know what? And we all got to go back into Genesis chapter 27 again. When you read Genesis chapter 27, Isaac, which is Yahweh Shai, Yahweh Shai is Isaac in reincarnation, okay? That was one of Yahweh Shai's former reincarnations, you know, Isaac. But Isaac, when he blessed Jacob, because he thought that Jacob was Esau, he thought he was blessing his firstborn, but it was meant for us to get that blessing anyway, okay? That was the purpose of the Most High. You read in Romans chapter 9. But the point is, when you read that, Isaac gave Jacob everything, man. When you read that, he gave us everything, period, man. Including Esau. Esau is one of those things that Isaac gave to us, man. He gave Esau to us as a slave. Read Genesis 27. Okay? Woo! Amen. And Brother Michael, amen, spirit, because the scripture that he posted, I was meditating on this because we in that time, man. All right, Revelation chapter 6, verse 11. You can link that up to Revelation 20 and 4, man. A lot of brothers about to die, man. But it ain't nothing to, once again, make you frantic. You know, but Revelation 20 and 4, that's written for a reason, okay? That's written for a reason. That's all I'm going to say. But let me read the scripture the brother posted. This by GMS, Behold, I Come Quickly, the brother Michael Allen from the Ancient of Days camp.
All right. GMS Ancient of Days, Revelation 6 and 11. And white robes were given unto every one of them, unto the elect. You know, and in particular, it's talking about the souls of them that were slain, okay, for the word of Yahweh Bashem Yahushua. And it was said unto them that they should rest yet for a little season. Rest where? Rest in the spirit world, which the head brother, the elder brother of war of our camp down in Mississippi, he actually had a vision that a lot of brothers had, you know, went to the spirit world, man, during this persecution. But he said the brothers that were in the spirit world, they were good. They were good, and they was basically looking down on the earth, you know, and they were, you know, looking towards Yahweh Bashem Yahushua. They were looking at Yahweh while Yahweh Shai in the heavens and basically begging the Lord and his son to bring the end sooner, to bring vengeance sooner, you know? Now it says, reading Revelation 6 and 11 again, and white robes were given unto every one of them, meaning that eternal life, man. Okay, and your sins being covered, the righteousness of saints. And it was said unto them that they should rest for a little season until their fellow servants, until their fellow servants also and their brethren that shall be killed as they were shall be fulfilled. That's going to happen in this time, man. Because when you read in Revelation chapter 6, that's dealing with end time prophecy. Okay, the four horsemen, that's dealing with the end times, man. Okay, that first horse being Yahushua. Okay, and you read about the rest of the horses, man. You know, the red horse being Esau. Okay, you got the black horse, but you got the horse and the person that was holding it held up those scales, which basically represented the financial collapse, the economic collapse, okay? And then you had the pale horse, which represented death, okay? Those death angels, with the main death angel or plague being that nuclear destruction. So Revelation chapter 6 is dealing with end time prophecies. So Revelation 6 and 11, on down, hey man, 6 and 11 and 12, it's talking about us, man, you know, in this time right now. Yeah, man. Hey, you know, the waterfall, you, I can tune in. I'm not going to be able to get every precept, but these are good scriptures, okay? Yeah, man. Let me get another one by the brother Michael Allah. Psalms 142 and 6. Attend unto my cry, for I am brought very low. Deliver me from my persecutors. Oh, man. That's scripture for the times, man. For they are stronger than I. That's the point, man. Hey, and you got Jakes. You got your simple-ass Jakes, man. And I'm talking about those of you that know that you're Hebrew Israelites. You all on social media, flaunting your damn guns, man. Proud you got a goddamn firearm. And you think that you can fight against Esau with that. You think that that's going to work against Esau. Esau, with his blessing, which is the sword, he's stronger than us with his blessing. But that's why you got to wait on your blessing, man. Your blessing is spiritual. You know, your blessing is Yahweh Bashem Yahushua. That's the only power that you have, man. But you niggas want to be like, well, the only way to come against Esau, you gotta use his blessing against him. You know, you gotta tap into Esau's blessing. You dumbass fools, man. Verse 7. Bring my soul out of prison. Woo! Amen. Like I said, man, I got to highlight this one. Like I said, man, this scripture or these scriptures is dealing with the times that we're in. Okay? Bring my soul out of prison. Certain brothers are going to be in some concentration camps, man. And you see. You wait and see. You wait and see. Because hey, a lot of you Jakes, man, you don't believe until the shit hits the fan, man. And a lot of times when the shit hits the fan, it's too fucking late. All right? You shouldn't need proof, man. And you know, also, who needs proof, man? You goddamn women. A lot of women need proof, and you're going to get all the proof you need, Eve. You're going to get all the fucking proof you need. Okay? Because women don't believe at all until all hell breaks loose. That's when they get in line. And a lot of you women are going to be put to death. You're going to get caught up during this time. Bring my soul out of prison that I may praise thy name. Right? And see, then shall they be known who are my chosen. Right? Because, see, the Lord is going to have you put in the concentration camp, but then he's going to deliver you from that camp just so you can praise his name, man. Glorify the name Yahweh, Ba'ashem Yahweh Shai, in the front of all the living, man. You know, because everybody can't see you praising the other names if you locked up. But the Lord is going to get you out of that situation, all right? The righteous shall compass me about, for thou shalt deal bountifully with me. Right, man? Because what does the scripture say? Ye who are troubled, rest with us. You know, you're going to wait with us, man. So we on the good side, man. We're in the safest place we can be. In this truth. Yeah, man. Like I said, I'm not going to be able to get every precept, but it's some heat on the comment board. All right. Yeah, it's some heat, man. But I tell you what, I'm going to close out with two more scriptures, and that's going to be it because I've been, you know, rolling the spirit. I've been going for a minute, but that's all right, too. I don't mind going. Okay. Hey, this is by two witnesses. Ain't the wide eye. This is a good scripture here. Proverbs 3:25. Be not afraid of sudden fear, neither of the desolation of the wicked when it cometh. Right, man? When the enemy shall come in like a flood. Don't be afraid of that. And it says sudden fear because Esau gonna roll on us out of nowhere, man. So it's going to be all of a sudden, you know, on a day you don't expect, man. He's just going to roll on Jake, man. The oddest time of the day, you know. But that's all right. Let him do it. This is by King Yehudah Maccabees 1:4-4, Job 15:35. They conceive mischief and bring forth vanity. And their belly prepared deceit. Their belly, talking about the belly of their mind. All right? Your desires are in your mind, not in your stomach. Okay? You know, so they desire evil against us, man. They conceive mischief. They're just making up shit, man, as they go. And it's all tacky, man. It don't even look right. Now, Esau's old tactics, his old techniques when he used to lie on people, you know, when he was sending, you know, agent provocateurs and crisis actors, it used to look believable. But now all this shit is like, man, come on, man. You know, you can tell it's set up. Okay? You know it's set up. All right, but let me close out with this scripture in the book of Isaiah. Because Esau is finished. And we got to remember that Yahweh Ba'ashem Yahweh Shai is still in control. Even though it looks like Esau is doing his own thing, the Lord is controlling him. What does it tell you? In Proverbs chapter 21, verse 1, how the king's heart is in the hand of Yahweh Ba'ashem Yahweh Shai. Okay? So the Lord, he's moving Esau in the direction where he wants to move him. Esau not doing his own thing, man. Okay? I'm going to close out with this. Isaiah chapter 51 and verse 12. I, even I, am he that comforteth you. And how does he comfort us? Through the Holy Scriptures. That's why the Bible is known as the Comforter. I, even I, am he that comforteth you. Who art thou that thou shouldest be afraid of a man that shall die? Right, so why are you afraid of Esau? Esau's going to fucking die, man. Ultimately. After that 1,000-year period of slavery, they're going to be extinguished from the earth, man. They're going to be erased as a nation of people. Okay? Who art thou that thou shouldest be afraid of a man that shall die, and of the son of man which shall be made as grass? Because Esau is still a man. He's still a mortal man. He can die. All right? Hey, man, you had David Rockefeller? It didn't matter how many goddamn heart transplants that devil had. Guess what? The Most High still required a spirit. He still dropped dead. Why? He's a man. He's still a damn man. Okay? Hey, man, get the fuck out of here, dude. Whoever the hell you are, all right? Get the fuck out of here, man. Judaism is bullshit, okay? Yeah, let me block your ass, okay? Yeah, get you out of here. Judaism is bullshit, okay? And you Jewish people are being exposed. You bunch of fucking liars, man. And the whole world is waking up to you. They're waking up to the fact that you are the problem. And you're not the real Jews, man. All right? You're Edomites. And me calling you an Edomite is greater than me calling you any damn, demonizing word, man. You know? I can call you a crack-ass cracker. I can say white person. You know, honky. I can call you, man, what else? Because, hey, Jake don't call Esau many things. Jake mainly called Esau a cracker, all right? You know, what's that one word, man? That one, I can't even think of it right now. But we call you different things, but really, there's nothing greater than me calling you an Edomite. Me calling you an Edomite is the worst thing I can call you, man. Okay? Well, it says the network is preparing. Hey, it's a damn system update. It's lucky for that. Hey, that's it, brother. The water. I couldn't think of it, but that's it right there. Peckerwood. Yeah, that's it right there. That's spirit, man. Yeah, Jay call you a damn peckerwood. Call you cracker. Call you honky. You know, but nothing is worse than us calling you an Edomite. You know? At the water for that, brother. Damn peckerwood, man. Because I was recalling that one movie, you know, where that one Jake, you know, what was his name, man? Is it Woodrow? But basically, man, was it Mandingo or Drum? But it was one of those slavery movies, right? Where pretty much Jake was hung because he didn't want to submit to Esau. All right? He didn't want to submit, so guess what? You know, hey, he got lynched, man. But yeah, at the same damn time, Esau, you're going down. It don't matter if you come for us. It don't matter if you put us to death. You're still going down, all right? Isaiah 51 and 13. And forgettest Yahweh thy maker. Right, so don't forget the power that put Esau in power, man. Don't forget the intelligence that is behind all this, man. Don't forget the director and producer of the movie. Okay? Yahweh Bashem Yahweh Shah. The Lord is still in control, man. It don't matter what Esau do. It don't matter what he say. The Lord is controlling Esau. Alright? Ain't the water, brother. Yeah, that was the name of the movie, Mandingo. You know, because you had those Mandingo fighters. Alright? And, you know, they showed you that even that one Mandingo fighter, at the end of the movie, Esau put him to death, man. You know, so you Jakes, man, you want to be all on Esau's side. You want to fight for Esau, do his bidding. You want to be against your brothers. Esau's still going to betray your ass, man. Why? He's the devil. He's an Edomite. All right? He's Esau. What you think he going to do? All right? And forgettest Yahweh thy maker, they have stretched forth the heavens and laid the foundations of the earth. Esau didn't create the earth. Esau tells you there is no creator. They tell you there was a big bang. Everything just came out of nothingness. Everything is random. The earth just here. This is what Esau believed. Okay? But we know the power that made all these things, man. So why are you going to be afraid of Esau? All right? And has feared continually every day because of the fury of the oppressor, as if he were ready to destroy. And where is the fury of the oppressor? Right. And that's the point right there. Here it is. You're afraid of Esau, as if he's ready to destroy you, because a lot of y'all are getting shaken up by this recent PSYOP. And there's going to be more PSYOPs. There's going to be more false flags. Okay, you're afraid of this. You're afraid of Esau. But the scriptures say, where is the fury of the oppressor? You know where it is. It's in the hands of Yahweh by Hashem Yahweh Shai. The Lord controlling Esau still. All right. And Esau, during Jacob's trouble, these devils are going to commit mass murder against our people. But the Lord is still behind them, man. The Lord is making them do it. Okay? And you got this damn nigga, man. I can't stand this nigga here, man. Side nigga from Sidenetta Studios, okay? Side nigga TV. You know, with the House of Consciousness. When Comfy's church got raided, you know, that guy, you know, the black discomforter, you know, Tazadakia. You know, which that guy, he's wicked as hell, man. But, you know, when his church, when his building got raided by the FBI, you had that damn dude, Saad Nigga, he was like, where's the Most High right now? Where's the effing Most High at right now? Well, the Most High controls everything, man, including Esau, and that throws people off. People can't understand how the Most High controls good and evil, man. That's why a lot of people don't believe in the Most High. You see infant babies get shot, you know? You see mothers drown their babies and babies get cooked in ovens, or you see people get chopped up, put in damn garbage bags, people falling off cliffs and, you know, trails of bodies out on the ground and trains derailing, you know? People committing suicide. How can there be a Most High and all these things are happening? All these natural disasters, all these people dying and wildfires. The Most High control everything, fool, okay? And the Most High can do what he want to do. So when all hell breaks loose, it's still the Most High behind it, man. And I just read it. Where is the fury of the oppressor? The fury of the oppressor is in the hand of Yahweh Hashem Yahweh Shai still, whether you believe it or not, okay? So yeah, man. Hey, man, I want to speak some more, but hey, through the Spirit, I think it's been edifying enough. Okay? Lord will, I can come back with some more lessons tomorrow. Or rather today, because we're in the next day already. Okay? But I tell you what, man. Hey, because I'm going to go with the Spirit. Since a lot of brothers are still on here, man, I'll read a few more scriptures. Because we go as long as the Spirit allows us to go. That's how we're supposed to teach, especially if it's a live show, okay? Because this is live, you're catching me in the spirit. This is by the brother Karamya Yashar Allah 4:4. Revelation chapter 2, verse 9. I know thy works and tribulation, Hold on. You know what? Let me read it in my Bible. I'll get it in my sword really quick. Revelation chapter 2 and verse 9. I know thy works and tribulation and poverty, but thou art rich. And I know the blasphemy of them which say they are Jews and are not, but are the synagogue of Satan. Hey, it's talking about Amalek. You so-called Jewish people, which ish is a suffix. It means to be like or pertaining to. It's like you have something that's brownish. It's really not the color brown, but it's brownish. It's close to brown, but it's not brown at all. Okay? Like you Edomites, you're imitating and you're seeking to be like us, but you can't be us. And you hate us because you ain't us, all right? You're not us. And that bothers you, the fact that you're not us. But it is what it is, man. You got to take that up with the Most High. You got to swallow that pill. You're not us. You're Edomites, okay? You're the synagogue of Satan. You're the chief house of Satan, okay? Yeah, man, bro, I was posting that heat. But yeah, it has been enough, though, you know, through the spirit. That's right. They're culture vultures. They took our nationality, man. Hey, by Esau taking our nationality, you got to think about that. Esau took the nationality of a whole nation of people. That's the greatest form of identity theft on the planet Earth, man. He took the nationality of a whole nation of people. That's big. That's pinnacle. This nigga, Esau, because he's the real nigga, walking around the whole planet Earth, claiming to be us. Claiming to be us, man. And he got to pay for that. And we're in the time he's going to pay for that. All right? Hey, the scriptures say the Most High is going to reward Esau and he shall know it. You're going to know it's the Most High paying you back, man. You know? Parading yourself around, claiming to be us, man. Lying your ass off, Esau. Okay? But you're going to pay for it, man. Yeah. And like scripture, bro, just posted, man. The Lord is going to utterly put out the remembrance of Amalek from under heaven. You know what that means? Esau will ultimately be exterminated. All right? After that 1,000-year period of slavery, which you will serve, under the nation of Israel, after that 1,000-year period of slavery, you Edomites will be exterminated. And it's talking about the tribe of Amalek, but it goes for the whole nation of Edom. You're going to be put out the earth, period, man. Because what is your remembrance? Your remembrance, that's talking about your seed line, your descendants, your progeny, your offspring. You have sons. Your sons have sons. They have sons. Your seed, that keeps your line going. Guess what? Ain't going to be no more seed of you. It tells you in the book of Obadiah, there should not be any remaining of the house of Esau. You know, which through the spirit, I've been all over the place in this lesson. The main point is during this time, we're not to deny the faith, man, because it's going to be some situations looking like it's going to be hard to get out of. All right, we're about to be faced with death because Esau knows he's out of here. He knows he's going in slavery. He knows that ultimately he's going to be wiped out. So he's not going down without a fight, okay? That's it, man. I mean, so much to say right now. The water for all you, I can tune in. You know, I got the elder brother Hawaii from North Carolina. Shalom, Akia. You know, and a lot of other brothers tuning in, ate the water. You know, a very few number of sisters on the comment board, you know, Shalom, you know, which really, you know, women should be quiet, okay? Really, hey, you women should just be quiet because the time we're coming into, really the woman should have nothing to say any damn way, you know? A lot of you women not going to make it, all right? Just to be honest, you know, and if you women are serious, if you're for real about this truth, just shut the fuck up, man, okay? I got to say it like that because a lot of you women talk too damn much. A lot of y'all talk too damn much. Just shut up, all right? But for you brothers, man, take this thing serious. Hey, the devil about to roll. But, hey, man, we're going to be all right, man, at the end of the day. So with that, I hope this is edifying. I know I've been rolling the spirit for a minute, but that's all right, you know. So I want to close out. I want to say, Barakatha Yahweh, Barakatha Yahweh Shah, 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 Bahashem, Rakak Wadash. Double honor to our apostles and elders, great millstone, still rule well. Peace and blessed to the hopeful elect of Israel. All right. You know, to you, Akim, you know, and you brothers, man, keep pushing. We almost up out of here. You know, Yahel Bashim Yahweh, Barakatham, Washamar Atham, Wah, Barak, Bayatka. All right. So the Lord bless you, the Lord keep you, and the Lord bless your house. The Lord bless you and your families. Okay. And also, I want to end with a curse. Yahweh, Bahashem Yahusha, Bahashem Rakakudash, Babakusha, 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 Shalak Rayam, Al Babal, Babakusha, Ababal, Babakusha, Ababal, Babakusha, Ababal, Yahweh, Bahashem Yahusha, Bahashem Rakakudash, Wa Shalak Rayam, Wa Anashim, Wa Abayim, Wa Haragim, Wa Mashapayim, Al Adawamim, Kau Adawamim, Wa Gawayam, Wa Ayabim Nawa. All right, Esau, Lord curse Esau and send evils on Esau, judgments, punishments, slayings, all right, on Esau, on the two thirds, all right. And I said, Gawayam, the nations, all right. The Lord sent evils and plagues upon this place, America, which is Babylon the Great, okay. And may the Lord destroy this place, man. All right. Baba Kusha, Baba Kusha, Baba Kusha, Yahweh Bashim Yahweh Shai, Bashem Rakakudash, the water, the water, the water, to water. All right. So, hey, man, you brothers stay strong. We almost up out of here. Yahweh Bashim Yahweh Shai, Barakatham, Wa Ababa Ba, Shalom.